Good morning, Gwen. Working Saturdays again, I see.
Yes. I'm trying to earn extra money to sock away before the great collapse occurs.
Good idea. But if you are saving money in banks, then you are probably wasting your time, because before long they are either going to inflate it away or simply steal it outright.
True. That's why I've been putting my savings in physical silver. But now that the CFTC has been overruled, I'm afraid that the silver manipulation will never be exposed.
The CFTC? Overruled? Ha 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 ho ho. Gwen, you are hurting me. Since when has the government ever prosecuted the government for corruption?
What do you mean?
Well, the CFTC. Are they part of the government?
Yes, I suppose.
And the courts, are they part of the government?
Yes.
And the Congress? Are they the government?
Of course.
And the Federal Reserve? Are they controlled by the government?
Well, since they were created by the Congress in 1913, and the Fed head is appointed by the President, then yes, I would say they are government too.
Okay. So what you are telling me is that you are upset because the government ruled that the government's regulations should not be applied to allow the government from stopping the government from manipulating markets.
Is that what I said?
In essence, yes. Because what happened is that the courts ruled that the regulations of Congress giving the CFTC power to stop the Federal Reserve from suppressing the price of silver shall not be enforced.
But I thought that the price of silver was being suppressed by the Wall Street banks like J.P. Morgan and others?
Really? And why would J.P. Morgan care what the price of silver is?
I don't know. Perhaps because of their large derivatives position might blow up.
That's not true. Because all of the banks already blew up in 2008 and were bailed out by the government. So why would they worry about that happening again?
Okay. I see your point.
Banks like J.P. Morgan have no inherent interest in the price of silver. Their traders make money regardless of whether prices go up or down.
Okay. So if the banks have no real interest in where the price of silver goes, who does?
Good question, Gwen. Let me ask you, have you ever heard of the London Gold Pool?
No. What was that?
Well, let's start with the Bretton Woods Agreement. Do you know what that was?
No. What was that?
The Bretton Woods Agreement was an international trade agreement which fixed the price of gold at $35 an ounce for all countries to trade with each other and to be able to redeem their dollars in gold.
Okay. And what does that have to do with the London Gold Pool?
A lot. Near the end of the 1960s, the gold price was verging on breaking the $35 price cap because America was printing so much money to pay for both guns and butter.
Go on.
So they formed the London Gold Pool to suppress the price of gold and keep the Bretton Woods system from collapsing.
I see.
So the governments of America and Europe conspired together to suppress the price of gold to keep Bretton Woods alive. But eventually they failed, and the price of gold ran from $35 to $850. That's when they created the petrodollar, because they could no longer control the price of gold.
Okay. So what's your point?
The point is this, Gwen. The failure of the London Gold Pool proves that it was the governments who were the ones behind the suppression of the gold price.
Yes, that's correct.
And the reason the governments were suppressing the price of gold is that the rising gold price was exposing their currencies for what they really were, worthless pieces of paper.
Yes, that's correct too.
So, as you know, today's silver price suppression is magnitudes greater than the one which occurred back then, because the amount of money is so much greater today, and the amount of silver is a tiny fraction of what existed back then.
So you are saying that things today are just like they were back then, where the government is suppressing the price of precious metals because the metals are threatening the existence of their worthless currencies?
Yes.
And to expect the CFTC or any other arm of the government to stop the government from doing this is absurd?
Correct.
And if it's the case that the government is behind the silver suppression, then how will it ever be stopped?
Let me ask you, Gwen. How was the London Gold Pool stopped?
Well, I guess it was stopped by the market seeing through the ruse and using dollars to buy physical gold, which broke the cartel.
Correct. And this one will be broken in the same way. By people using their worthless paper dollars to buy physical silver until the cartel is buried.
Good point. I've got to go now and order more physical silver.
Excellent. Goodbye.